guys. It is very overcast. The storm is definitely coming. We are got a few supplies last night. This morning we are heading to
Hollywood Studios. The rain and the thunderstorms are supposed to start at 4, so yep. We're going to go try and get Rise of the Resistance and Minnie Mickey's Runaway Railway done, because we've not done them yet. Then we're going to come out and just take it as it comes. Doubt we'll get into the park tomorrow.
No, so I think the hurricane's going to start coming tonight, guys. So
enjoy our last
day. We'll enjoy what we can for a couple of hours this morning, because if we don't, we think we might not get to say goodbye to Disney at all. We think yesterday might be a goodbye. So we're going to head in, say a little bit of a goodbye, and let's go do it. We're a bit late, it's 11 a.m. sorry, and we're just going to try and have a couple of hours, just taking a little bit more of Disney before we have to call it a day. I think the rain and thunder and lightning is to come round about 3-4 o'clock, so we'll just get as much as we can done. Guys, we've packed the ponchos and we'll see what we can get up to. Potentially our last tap into the park. It's pretty busy. Not too busy, but it is pretty busy. I think everybody's taking in that last bit of Disney, guys, before Hurricane Ian arrives. Dining area, which if you didn't watch, guys, we did do a vlog in one of our previous videos we had in there on our first day in here, so if you've not caught that, maybe give that a try. Anybody who's familiar with the parks probably guess what direction we're heading in already. Resist it. One last day, this is the park we had booked on this day, so if we don't get back on Disney property before we go home, at least I've been to Batu one more time, and Alicia loves it here too. For Rise of the Resistance, it is a 2.5 hour wait, but we haven't done it, and we didn't get to do it last time out here because it wasn't ready, so we're going to brave it today. Inside the base, guys, this is completely lost on Heather, but I am loving the theming as we go into the cave. In here, guys, but they've got some of the flight crew outfits all behind the cages. They had some blasters in the last one too. It's pretty cool. So guys, it looks like we're about to filter in with Lightning Lane here, and we've been in line for about an hour and 25 minutes. Insults are flying, guys.
BB-8, is everyone assembled there? Good. Shouldn't you be in flight prep? Recruits, thank you for joining the cause. A covert resistance team led by my friend Finn has infiltrated a First Order Star Destroyer that is now headed to this system. Your outpost on Batu is no longer safe. We have transports waiting to take you to General Organa's secret base on Pakala. I'll regroup with you there. The Resistance desperately needs your help in our fight against Kylo Ren and the First Order. Remember, it is vital that you keep the location of the Pakala base secret. Lieutenant Beck, one of our top commanders, will lead you.
Affirmative. Transport is ready. Line Number 9 shall personally see them delivered.
Thank you, Lieutenant. Welcome to the cause. May the Force be with us.
Commander, Black Leader, I hear you're a fine-looking group of recruits. Well, no time to waste. Let's get you on your way to the General.
Ground crews, deck is in motion. Recruit crossing to transport.
That's better. Check the binary motivator. Yes, check the hyperdrive also.
Transport takeoff in 20 seconds.
Crew systems normal. Engage repulsors and hold on.
Inbound recruits. More ships. Launch. I am Lieutenant Beck. As you heard from Ray, I have been tasked with getting you to Vakara.
Red 2, Blue 5, keep tight now. Let's get ready to make that jump to light speed. On my mark.
Black Leader, we're picking up an unusual signal. Are you spotting anything?
Yeah, I see it. We'll check it out. BB-8, what do you got?
There appear to be a number of small craft heading our way. Raise the shields.
We got company. First order TIE fighters. Reroute. Reroute. Red 2, Blue 5, we got a clear path so transport can make a jump.
Get us clear so we can make the jump.
Be ready. You won't have much time.
Where are all those TIE fighters coming from? Star Destroyers. We can't. We're caught in a tractor beam. It's pulling us in.
I'll get some friends and make us a fair fight. Don't worry, I'll come back for you. Stay strong.
Captain boarded.
This is TR-141. We are a civilian vessel. By whose authority are we being detained?
By the authority of the First Order, Resistance Scum. Now bring down your shields and prepare to be boarded.
This ship is now under the command of the First Order. You will disembark immediately and head to your right for processing and interrogation. All of you, off now. All of you, get off now.
Wait,
no, everyone off, like I just said. Listen to what I say here.
Send more spot. Three this way. Three against the wall, single file. As for the group of eight, you're going to make a random line when you paint. Zero bullets there.
We will soon snuff out your meager resistance. You chose the wrong side, and now you will pay. The resistance prisoners.
You have what I want. You know the location of the secret base, and I will take it from you.
We are needed on the bridge.
Keep the prisoners here. I will return to finish this personally.
We are being rescued.
Head down to the escape pod base. Those droids are programmed to return you to Vatir. Hurry and don't get caught. Which is Beck will guide you.
For your safety, stay seated with seatbelts securely fastened. Keep hands, arms, feet, and legs inside the transport and supervise your children. Tell them it's a prisoner transfer. Did it work? Good. Now get a move on. There's a clear path to the turbo lifts at the end of the hallway. Turn right. Droid. You're lucky it didn't spot you. Take those turbo lifts and stay out of trouble.
Hey, you're not authorized.
Wait, those are the prisoners.
We have a range of detention lock three.
Find an alternate route. Who picked these two droids anyway?
Detention globe breach. Treatment lock C on the
this does not look good. Try to find another way down to the escape pods.
The resistance will attempt to rescue them. prisoners.
They have neither the resources nor the courage to engage us.
You underestimate their conviction. Raise the shields!
Shields? I see no evidence.
Now!
Sound the alarm! All personnel to their stations!
The prisoners have escaped.
How brave, but ultimately hopeless. There's nowhere to run.
Fire the mental cannons!
You outside the wreck. Okay, your door's stuck.
Why is that always a thing?
There, see? I told you it wouldn't be a problem. All right, nice job, recruits. Not what you signed on for, but hey, it's your resistance now. I think I have that authority.
Where's the lieutenant?
I need eyes on Beck!
We're tracking Beck's part of the wreckage,
sir. Wreckage? You got a bad feeling about this.
No, sir. He came down at the wreckage site.
That doesn't sound good. He was the backbone of this operation.
We are initiating extraction protocol.
Lieutenant Beck here.
Beck! You're alive!
I should hope so. Great job, recruits. Thanks to your heroism, the location of the resistance base is secure. Bravo! Yes, R5, you too.
Say goodbye to the little droid that saved us all.
If you're a Star Wars fan, that is mind-blowing.
That is a must if you're a Star Wars fan.
That was phenomenal.
We both had, and it was absolutely brilliant.
Honestly, guys,
so good.
I'm going to be pumped for the rest of the day. It was about a 2-hour wait, and which is a lot less time than what it said, but it was worth the wait.
Oh, definitely. It was brilliant.
So, guys, we say goodbye to Batu for at least another 3 or maybe 4 years, so that was awesome. What a way to say goodbye.
The plan for the day, guys, is to grab Mickey and Minnie's Runaway Railway, as it's the other ride in this part that we haven't experienced yet before we call it a day. We just thought we'd come in and get a couple of hours of Disney before we could say goodbye.
A quick update on the hurricane. We have now been updated to hurricane watch rather than tropical storm watch.
Yep.
And Orlando International Airport is closed, so that's looking like we 100% won't be back into any part.
No, I think the airport closing for 2 days is not a good sign. This is our second try at this. It got broke down just as we got to it last time, so fingers crossed. A couple of minutes in here and then you're almost ready to go into the pre-show. We'll be on the next load. The pre-show happens and then we walk through and get on the ride, hopefully within 5 minutes after that roughly.
or like we did last time, we walked through the pre-show and then got evacuated.
These good people into the cartoon while they fix this here locomotive?
I guess I can do that for you, Goofy.
Thanks! Be back in a jiffy to pick you all up!
Nothing was gonna go wrong. Oh, yeah.
children must be fully seated at all times under the lap bar.
Runaway railway was good.
Yeah, it was good.
I think it's one. Did we get in the queue at one? It's two now. So we're on and off in about an hour. It was good.
Yeah, it was good.
I'm glad we've done it, but I'm not like. It's not one of the ones that if we'd done it early in the holiday, I'd be desperate to do it again. I don't mean anything bad by that. I just don't think it's worth an hour. There you go, Heather. Heather would wait over an hour for it. I don't think I would. I think 45 minutes below, definitely. But the queue's been consistently high, so. We're glad we've done it though, absolutely. It was really good. And now Alicia's going to have a little look in the shop before we head on out. Alicia got her bag, Heather got the Walt Disney print on the yellow top, and Alicia went for the sort of pinky coloured Florida Walt Disney World. Headed over to use the restroom, I'm going to get to wave to Donald and Daisy. Got to orchestrate in the crowds here. Sadly, that is us for Disney. I think Storm Ian, or Hurricane Ian now as we should call it, is on its way very soon, and we probably won't be getting back in the park. Right now we're just worrying about how we're going to get home on Friday. If everything's going well, we should do that. The airport's closed until 10:30 a.m. guys, just to give you an idea of the hurricane update that we've got just now. So it is a sad goodbye to Disney for now, and that is us for the day.
Yeah.
Liam popped over and picked us up from the park, and we decided to come over to Celebration. And if you've seen our vlog from the other day, you'll know why. Because we enjoyed the Coldstone Creamery, and Heather had not long had food, and Heather didn't manage hers. She didn't want one. So we decided to come back because we loved it. So we'll show you a little look in here. Coldstone Creamery. We're going to have a little look at the menu, guys, but I think I'll maybe get what we got the other day. All these different flavours of ice cream. And here's all the toppings. Heather's gone for a small cheesecake ice cream with Kit Kat. And some marshmallows from the Lucky Charms. Some caramel sauce. There they are. That is awesome. So Alicia got the strawberry ice cream with caramel and
chocolate chips.
Heather went for cheesecake, as we showed you. The small ones were about just over $7, including tax. And that's a large, guys, and it was $8.25. We had pudding first, a little bit backwards, but that was just because we were close to the Coldstone Creamery. And there's no rain yet. We thought it would come about 2 or 3 o'clock. It is now 3:15, and we're going to head on into the outlets because Heather would really like to try some orange chicken. We sampled it in the food court the other day, and it was really tasty. So that's what Heather's going to have for her lunch. Do believe it was the Chinese factory right here that we tried earlier, so Heather's going to get in line and see what that's all about.
And Heather both went for the same thing. They did the two-bit entree combo, half rice, half noodles, and they both got orange chicken and bourbon chicken. And we've all had a little trial, but it's awesome. I'm not sure what me and Alicia are going to have, but I'm not sure Heather will manage all that, but she's certainly enjoying what she's got.
While those guys are having something to eat, we're going to nip into the character warehouse, and if they've still got the lounge fly down to $42 with the premium bar, we're going to buy it for Heather for her Christmas while she's not watching. The Donald and Daisy one's new from the last time we're here. It is $37.99, and so is the Dumbo one over here. We've got a Marvel one here, guys. It's $46, and the Pretzel one, which is one of the ones that Heather was looking at, is $43. The Epcot one we seen the other day is still here, guys, and it's $38 too. We've picked up this Epcot colourful spirit jersey. It's $25.99 instead of the $75 that most of them wear in the parks. This one's a medium, the last medium we could get in the shop. Alicia's also picked up these guys. The set is about $40 in total. just under $40 including taxes for the set. Just to give you an idea of the bargains we've just got, that is $101 guys for a full set that Alicia got in pink, the spirit jersey we got Heather for Christmas, and the lounge fly we got Heather for Christmas. Alicia and I are going to get a Charlie's Philly cheesesteak because we had that 3 years ago and it was really, really tasty. I went for the classic without the rabbit food. Alicia went for the chicken, all salad intact, and we're just going to share a soda. Food in the tummy and still not having any rainstorms yet, but the weather watch that Alicia's got on her phone does not look nice as the day progresses. But it's 4:15, we're going to nip to Walmart and grab some, I think some sleeping aids and stuff for later.
Hello guys,
so guys,
how are you?
We just bumped into theme park Ohana. So we're just going to say hi and let them get on with their day. They're all preparing for Storm Ian.
It was awesome to say hi to theme park Ohana. Jen told us it's her birthday in a couple of days, and how inconsiderate of Storm Ian to come along and close the parks for Jen's birthday. They were going to check into Old Key West, I think she said. So, however, I hope she has a lovely birthday, and we're going to go into Walmart and see if we can get a few things, guys.
Heather loves pushing the trolley over here. I don't know why, but she likes to get a shopping cart. She doesn't like pushing it at home, guys, let me tell you that much. As expected, it is a bit manic in here. The queue for the checkout is very long, but we're going to need to try and get some bits and pieces. Here's the shelves for the water, or the lack of it, and they're just popping these out and they're two per customer.
Tip, we did just get some snacks and some pink lemonade for the room. We have got some water and stuff left, but we went to the basket bit and self-checked out. You can also use cash or card there, guys, and it was much quicker. So that was quite good. We're going to go back to the hotel and chill out and see what comes of the storm. I say, if you're actually do have a check out of theme park Ohana's vlogs, they also do stroller hire, which I'm not sure that'll be helpful for the UK. I'm not sure how easy it would be, but I know from the US guests it's pretty helpful, they do that as well. So check out their vlogs, guys. And yeah, we didn't show you too much of Walmart. It was packed, wasn't it? And the line that you seen went all the way to the back of the store with trolleys. It was manic trying to get the down the aisle where the water was being handed out. It was almost like people fighting over what was there. But there was more pallets coming out, and we did hear the girls at the checkout saying that the Walmart, they're trying to stay open till 6 p.m. tomorrow to allow people to get in, but that will obviously be staff dependent and what the storm brings. So
we're all on our way back home from Walmart, and every one of us just got a massive fright of a life because we all got a storm alert, a hurricane alert on our phones, and it made a really loud
drastic
noise.
Yeah, siren.
Four phones going all at the one time, guys, making a really loud siren noise. So yep, I hope everybody who's out here with us is home watching this safely whenever they do get home, anybody who was out here. And fingers crossed the next few hours bring less damage than we think it might.
We've put some washings on, we've got everything we need in the fridge in the room. And as I say, it's looking, the power outages are classed as being likely, so we've just got to sit tight, guys, and we'll give you a little hurricane update. But this might be the end of the vlog, and if it is, guys, I hope you've enjoyed watching what we've done. We had a good day as best we could, and we will see you on the next one, guys. Bye bye.